everyone. Counting is very important in music. Listen to what happens if we don't count. Beethoven will be really upset if we play like that. In this lesson, we are going to learn the easiest way to count. Notice how this passage consists mainly of 16th and 8th notes. In general, the easiest way to count is to set the metronome to the shortest note. In this case, we set the metronome to the 16th note. Tick, 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 tick. Instead of writing tick 4 times, we write 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's why we call keeping a beat counting. But when we play, there is no need to say the numbers out loud. We just follow the ticking sound. Ready to give it a try? Here we go. Get the hands ready. Go faster. Let's try 72. Instead, we'll make the metronome slower. Back to 60, but this time we're going to play 2 notes for every tick. Now I'm going to keep it on 60, but try to fit 4 notes in there. Shows you it's actually harder to count fewer beats. So that's why it's good to practice by using the smallest note. Are you convinced? In case you're wondering about that half measure in the front, that is called a pick-up measure. Mozart's father, Leopold, wrote this piece. He wanted Amadeus to stress the notes in the beginning of each measure, and that is why he made a time signature of 2-4. The first measure of each note is usually a little louder. In the next lesson, we will sight read the rest of the piece. See you then.